Hi. Okay, so I am making homemade dog food because my oldest dog is getting really picky, not wanting to eat, and the higher end dog foods, which we have fed them really good dog food, but she's tired of that. So I thought I'm going to make homemade dog food, but I'm going to do a taste test. But I wanted to show you real quick what I've got here. I've got petite sirloin, tilapia, got potatoes and carrots in there. Got hash browns going in there, rice here. We got some chicken that's gonna be going in, maybe some bananas and some sweet peas. Not necessarily all mixed together, but I got my little Barkley right down there. Don't know if you can see him. And I'm gonna put this dish in front of him, and the white is the tilapia. The brown, of course, is the beef. And I wanna see what he's gonna go for first. So let's watch and see what he does. And then I'm gonna do my other dog. Oh, decisions. Oh. Okay. So he went for the beef. I'll come back and let you know if he eats the tilapia. Oh, here he comes, wow. I don't know if he even ate that. Let's see what he does here. Now the fish was actually cooked in some lamb oil I already had in a pan. Oh, he loves that. Oh boy. He literally scarfed up the tilapia. Let's see if he's going to eat this and chew it or just inhale it like he does. Now look at that. Barkley, was it good? Was it good, honey? Yummy! Okay, so let me make sure this is still going. We just had Barkley try it. He started with the beef, came over, and then engulfed the tilapia. So I've got the same here for Zoe. We got the beef and the tilapia. She's the one that's almost 15. She's not liking her food that she's kind of always eaten. Let's see what Zoe chooses. So she's looking at the beef, now checking out the fish. Go ahead, Mom. Okay, so she goes in first for the beef as well. Might be a little hard for her to chew up because her teeth aren't very good. Have to mush it up a little bit more. So she ate all the beef first. Let's see if the fish is appetizing to her. Well, she's definitely thinking about it. Okay. This is the whole reason I'm making homemade food, is because, bless her heart, she does not want to eat her old stuff. So she doesn't quite lick her plate as clean as Barkley does. Good job, Mom. Was that yummy? Yeah? Good job. Hi. So I showed a couple of videos of my dogs trying the dog food. Well, just the meats. And I kind of showed you what I made. But I prepared all this different stuff and I'm going to show you. My kitchen's a big mess because I've made it a mess doing this. But so you'll see that in here is potatoes, carrots, and peas just boiled in plain water. Then I strained them out. There is some tilapia that I actually cooked in some, lamb oil that I had. I had done a leg of lamb in my pan, and so I just browned it, cooked it in there. Here is just some leftover hash browns that were kind of starting to go bad in the freezer, so I cooked them up. Here's some brown rice. They say to only use brown rice in dog food. And here is some cornmeal that I've just used with some water, a little bit of oil, and just cooked it over the stove good. And then I haven't got this out yet, but in here is chicken breasts. So I'm just kind of this is what I'm doing. Oh, and then right here, I have already used my Cuisinart food processor, and I've already mulched up the petite sirloin. It was the cheapest today, so that's what I went with for the beef. So right now I'm in the process of making the beef dog food. Here's some already done, as you can see. And then I'm going to be packaging it, but I thought I would show you real quick. So I just take a scoop of the beef and put it in the processor. And I'm gonna grab a, it's hard to do this one-handed, but I'm doing this video on my own. Grab a good scoop of the veggies and put the veggies in the processor. Okay, plus I got my phone turned away from me. I'm gonna grab just a little bit of the hash browns. These were just an afterthought. Heck, you can use a whole bunch of fun stuff in dog food. And just go through your freezer, find some meat that maybe has freezer burn that the family might not like, but the dogs will still love it. These were hash browns that were going old. I'm gonna grab, I don't wanna do a ton of brown rice or a ton of the cornmeal. So I just together do a little less than a cup of that. Okay, and I'm gonna pour that in there. And then I am actually going to pour in a little bit of water just for the processing part of it. Okay. Put on my lid. I'm gonna turn it off for just a minute. Shut it off. I don't want it completely like a pate. I want it more a little bit chunky. So then I'm just gonna pulse it a little bit, and then I like to check it, and that's how quickly it gets done, and the consistency is absolutely perfect. As you can see, I just gave some to my dogs and they snarfed it right up. Now I didn't use any seasonings. I just used my seasoned cast iron skillets. Actually, they had season in them. I hadn't cleaned them out, so just use that. Little bit of oil. I just used vegetable oil and water and did all of them in that and just kind of used the same pans for them so they all kind of seasoned. So then I'm going to package this. Last time I did it, I put it in, I did this the vacuum seal, but I think this time I'm just going to put it in plastic bags and freeze them up. So then I just pull out one plastic bag at a time. So I hope this helps and hopefully my dogs will love it, and have a good one. Bye. Okay, so now I'm gonna try to show you how I'm wrapping this dog food. So I have my great big Costco Saran Wrap. I pull out plenty, give it a little slack. I've found that 2 cups, about 2 cups, works great. And I'm making these into loaves. So once I get it on the Saran Wrap, just kind of making that into a bit of a loaf. And I'm gonna take this end, I'm gonna overlap it big time because I don't want the freezer, it to freeze into the food and have it be hard to open. So, and then I just roll it and kind of making a loaf as I do it. I cut off the Saran Wrap, finish wrapping it, and I have all these loaves that are gonna go inside of gallon freezer bags, and I'll pull one loaf out at a time.